Shalom, shalom, mashalom pa, mashalom may. I pray that everything is tawab. First of all, giving all praises to the God of our forefathers, God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, whose proper name is Yahweh. All praises due to the Most High in Christ. Let me ask you a question. Did you once have a dream? And are you living that dream? Let me ask you another question. Everyone under the sounds of my voice right now. Wouldn't you want to know how that you could actually live that dream? I called this lecture right here. This is a life transformative lecture. I entitled it Secure Party Creditor Law of Attraction. It's the Secure Party Creditor's Law of Attraction. Comparison equates death. Start your dream business with no money. Use commercial debt. You heard me correctly. Stop comparing yourself to anyone. Comparison equals death. You could start your business with no money by using commercial debt. Everyone in the sounds of my voice right now, may I ask you another question? In fact, a few more questions. Did you know that we primarily all have dreams as children? Did you once have a dream that actually seemed to be literally crushed by bad choices that you made in life? Wouldn't you agree that if you could actually finance your entire transaction of that dream, whatever field of endeavor, whatever it may have actually been, with no equity, would you do it? Doesn't it make sense to finance the entire transaction with no money? Like I did just a few days ago. I financed a S550 Mercedes Benz. No money down. I have a perfect credit score. Do you want to learn how this works? Or do you want to just jump from YouTube channel to YouTube channel and keep getting the same old results, which is disappointment? Well, if you want to learn how this works, if you answered yes to any of those questions, you need to watch this entire video and do everything suggested here. Your worry hasn't been working. I was told that that's actually the definition of insanity. You're consistently doing the same things. Why not try what's different? Why not try to go against what you've actually been taught, your belief system? And so this is not legal advice. I do not offer legal advice. If you need legal advice, seek yourself a competent counsel and then please be advised. Everything I'm about to give you is from personal experience and is for informational and educational purposes only. And I can tell you it works because I'm living it out right and exact, God. Doing some things that I suggest in this video won't work. You have to do everything suggested here. And please, like the video, subscribe to the channel if you're not already subscribed, and click the notification bell. And it would be nice if you would actually go and fund me for the right knowledge that I give, that I've been given for the past 10 years, that have actually transformed many of your lives, many of which was actually unworthy, because I never heard from you again. But karma is a biatch in a mini skirt. And she's not necessarily standing on a corner. You understand? Even a Neo cannot see. Neo cannot see that I'm the original white man, according to the law, because they don't know law. So let me ask you, how many of you have actually taken classes on how to buy a business? How many of you have actually taken courses on how to sell a business? If you'll be honest, just about none of you. I would go to the extreme and say none of you. But it's essential to learn these things. As a secure party creditor, this is what you're learning from my books and my DVDs. Why not make the investment? How many of you are willing to do what's required? As a secure party creditor, let me ask you, how many of you have wills? How many of you under the sounds of my voice right now have wills? What if something would actually happen to you? Let's say you're quite successful, right? And if you don't have a will, if you die, which is imminent, you're going to die. If you don't have a will, your property goes into probate court. How do you know, Tazadaq? Because I get various calls of people that have houses and other property in probate court, and they don't know what to do. You know why? It's because the parent or the spouse didn't leave a will. This can be avoided by becoming a secure party creditor. Go to our website now, truedisciplesofchrist.org/shop, and become a secure party creditor. You are actually set up with a trust that covers your property. But you would not believe how many debtors call me because their spouse or their parent died and their property goes into probate court. Don't tell me what you know. I don't care about your degree. They've educated you to be a fool. And I forgive me for talking to you that way, but you're working for someone else. That's not freedom. They don't teach you about money. They don't teach you how to make money work for you. They teach you how to go out and work for money, even with your PhD, with your master's. But through the grace of the Most High God, God Almighty, and this is God's work, by the way. This is your house work. It's not Tazadaq's work. 3 days ago, I walked into a bank with no social security number and asked for a $120,000 loan on an SS5, on an S550 Mercedes-Benz. I didn't leave until I got approved. It only took about 20 minutes because I have a perfect credit score. No money down. This is the best way to do it. You see, what I'm trying to suggest to you, family, is I use commercial debt. If I did it, a little Negro from the ghetto that they told would be nothing, that they said would most likely not to succeed, that they say would be a failure. Look at me now, teacher. I wasn't supposed to be here. Remember me? Tazadaq Shah. You said he wouldn't make it. They can't determine who I am. The bank opened at 9 a.m. that morning. I was there at 8:45. And I always look for a fairly new bank. Because first thing, there's not going to be that many customers as any. I was actually the first customer that day. No banks. I mean, no customers except Tazadaq. So I asked the bank officer, what is your legitimate legal limiting amount? Your legal limiting. He said, well, I could lend up to $120,000. I said, perfect. That's awesome. I only need $199,000.99. And so I want you to keep in mind, family, that 75% of all bank loans are made within the last 90 days of the year. Those are the easiest loans to get. Go figure. Now, for the next several months, your job is to invest 30 minutes a day by reviewing, memorizing, and practicing the expressions in this video, in my books, The Inviolable Man. You're going to have to get the books in order to be able to do this, because I'm going to show you how you could do what I've done. I can't make this up. I'm living it out. You see me. Stop acting as if you don't see me. So, over the next 90 days, Your job is to invest 30 minutes at least, at a minimum, 30 minutes a day reviewing, memorizing, and practicing the expressions in this video, and in my book, The Inviolable Man, and in my book, The Corporation versus We the People, and my latest seminar DVD from Atlanta. In order to do that, you're going to actually have to donate for these items, obviously. Now, you should make it your goal to read those two books a minimum of 10 times during the last 90 days. If you don't do this, it's not going to work for you. Now, I'm giving you the game. You should carry these two books with you everywhere you go. And I want you to fill out this daily progress report that I'm going to put up at the end of this video. And so on and so forth. Actually, I'm going to try and link it below. If I can't link it below, then I'll post a link and put it on my website. And you'll be able to go there and download it for free. A daily progress report. Each time you reread the chapters in each book. And like I, Tazadaq, say, inch by inch, anything is a cringe. But yard by yard, everything is too damn hard. So once you begin memorizing the material in Tazadaq's, my books, you need to start using it immediately. You must overcome fear. Fear is an intangible. It doesn't really exist. It only exists in your mind. You create the fear, therefore you can overcome it. So listen up, family. I'll guarantee you this. This is a guarantee. This is my guarantee to you. And my word is my bond, and my bond is my life. And I will give my life before my word shall fail, God. Peace to the gods. I could guarantee you this. If you mastered the material in my books and on that DVD and use what you've learned to present the material opportunity with posture 4 to 6 times, then 4 to 6 times a week, you'll be well on your way to success and successful in little or no time. How do we do this? We do this by asking questions. Remember I said years ago, he that is asking is as the king. That's an aphorism worth remembering. He that is asking is as the king. A lot of people repeat the phrase. They don't really comprehend it, right? It is not what you tell your players that count. Those of you that play basketball, right? Tennis, right? It is not what you tell your players that count. It's what they hear. So just like the basketball court, the maritime admiralty court, it's a game. See, your problem has been is that you've actually been getting your tactics from a lot of different YouTube channels. You've gone from YouTube channel to YouTube channel, being led and falsely taught and misguided by fly-by-night YouTubers that only knows bits and pieces of knowledge, yet suddenly they end up teaching you. You see a video up, it sounds rational, so you follow it. And to make matters even worse, you go and you start trying to teach after studying this for a year. Are you writing books now? You study this for a year. The scriptures say in the book of Matthew 15, verse 14, take heed to this, right? If the blind lead the blind, they both shall fall in the ditch. You got blind people leading blind people. You're following blind people and you wonder why you're not getting remedy. Then you start to doubt that the secure party creditor law of attraction is not real. I came up with that term, the secure party creditor law of attraction, because that's what this is. It's only been attracting positive things in my life. See, I teach you to overcome aphasia and to correctly speak the language needed to win. You can't shortcut this. You must order the books that I suggested, the two books at least. Really, you should order all of my books, but you should at least order those two and that DVD to learn to start speaking this language, right? Watch this. So I'm giving you the game, and Anybody out there that's rich, that's wealthy, they can confirm what I'm saying. You see, you must learn to speak the language, right? Every business has its own jargon, its own special language. So it is with the law. So it is with the court system. Everybody who ever operated a computer, right, had to learn keywords and phrases in order to communicate, such as what a hard drive is, such as what software is, such as what, hey, USB drive is, and so on and so forth. It's the same way with this court system and this system of law, or should I say colorable law. Now, before my career in computer networking and programming, I was a successful salesman. I worked for many of the major companies. The first thing that I had to do to sell products was to learn how to build communication bridges. Most of you have that problem. You don't know how to do this. I'm not insulting you. I'm just telling you how to change your life and make it better. I didn't say, for instance, this MacBook will cost you $1,200. The company will bill you by mail. I learned to say, your premium is only $1,200, a very reasonable investment. Wouldn't you agree? See, the most, what I learned, right? And I was a top salesman. I was winning top salesman so many times and winning so many gifts that they started to say, hey, this guy's winning every time. And so what I learned is that the most successful agents knew how to talk the talk. They knew what to say and when to say it. It's the same way in the game of court, man. And with law, it's the same way. What is your status? Who are you? Where do you live? What is your country? Same way in law, folks. See, what most people mistake for a God-given talent that they see in tazadaq is really a hard-earned skill. I fell, I get back up. I fell, I get back up. Believe me, most people that are successful weren't born with the gift of gab. But what we were born with was the same thing that all other people are born with. The desire to learn, to improve, to grow, and most of all, to excel and soar. And if you don't have that, stop watching this video right now. I'm dead serious. Because essentially, you're wasting my time, and more importantly, you're wasting your own time. And I don't want you to do that. Now, may I ask you another question? Do you really want to change your life? Are you tired of making excuses of why you have not succeeded? Wouldn't you agree that something is wrong with the court system, with the system in general, that you got to work most of your life? You spend more time at work than you do with your loved ones. Don't you see that something's wrong? Wouldn't you agree? Isn't something wrong with this world, the way it's functioning? Can't you see that only about 1% of the population is truly where they want to be? And the other 99% is, hey, wanting to be like them. Doesn't it make sense to invest in being a secure party creditor by ordering my books and DVDs if it's going to really save you thousands in the future? Does that not make sense? If so, go to the website now. You see it on the screen. www.truedisciplesofchrist.org. Change your life. What are you waiting for? This is not a sales pitch. I'm giving you love. I'm really trying to help you change your life. Isn't it also true that people don't care how much you know until they know how much you really care? Well, I care. This is why I'm doing. I don't have to do this. I don't have to do this. I really care. To everyone in the sounds of my voice right now, may I ask you another question? If you could show other people what I'm about to show you, right? And if I could show you the tools that could actually double or triple your confidence, significantly impact your self-worth and your worth to others, and thus positively impact your income, would you use it? Well, great. Awesome. Then you better get busy memorizing and using the question, phrases, and words of wisdom in those two books, The Inviolable Man and The Corporation, and the DVDs that I mentioned at the inception of this this video. See, you first have to have those two books, so order them right now, and you got to get that DVD. It's one of the best investments you'll ever make in your life. Have fun. Be successful. Remember, success is a journey. It's not a destination. Because once you reach your destination, you become complacent. You become content. I'm always that lion running up the hill, right? Now, can you realistically accomplish your dreams with what you are currently doing? Can you realistically accomplish your dreams with what you're currently doing? If not, why not try what I'm offering? Isn't it true that why you do something is more important than what you do or how you do it? Is that not true? See, my words set fires under your ass and make you think. It sits fire under your ass. The fires of your motivations are fueled by your dreams, but you've forgotten how to dream. The dream of today would be the reality of tomorrow, but most people have forgotten how to dream. See, when I was working for someone else, I was building someone else's dream. You're going in every day to a 9-to-5, sometimes longer than that, building someone else's dream. But now I'm working for myself. A little nobody, they said, from the hood that wasn't supposed to make it. That was going to end up in prison and drugs and so on and so forth, or either dead on the street. That's what they had planned for me. But this is God's plan. You understand? This is God's work. This is Yahweh's work. It's not mine. I'm being directed by a higher deity. Do you understand? But you got to have a dream. I'm building my dream. I'm no longer working for someone else. Got a lot of haters coming out. That's materialistic. Okay, roger that. The Lord blessed Solomon. Many riches. The Lord blessed King David with many riches. The Lord tells me we're supposed to be kings and priests. So don't come around me with that foolish talk about being poor, raggedy, hungry, naked, and in the damn hood. It's not for me, man. You could choose that life, but that's not where I want to be. I operate on a higher level of vibration. If you want to stay down there with the weeds in life, you can listen to that talk. Because I surround myself by people that get it. This is why I cut people out of my life every day. See, you've got to have a dream, family. You've got to have a dream. You are whatever you are willing to fight for. You willing to fight for this? Secure party credit, the law of attraction? This is why cowards are nothing. They're nothing but cowards. Have you ever heard the story of the man that was almost great? Me either. You know why? Because no one's talking about that. No one's talking about someone that was almost great. They talk about the great, the people that defiled the odds. The world's going to remember my name. You're going to remember that I said that. You can remember that. I said, he's a little nobody from the hood. Came up, blew up. Yeah, I remember when he was making YouTube videos way back. That's what you're saying right now. You see me saw him, right? You already see the growth, don't you? You see how I've grown, don't you? You can't doubt it. You can't doubt it. You see me. Stop acting like you don't see me. I wasn't supposed to be here. Remember, you was prophesying this nigga ain't locked up yet. Some of you even said that to me. Okay, roger that. This is God's work. This is the Lord's work. This is Yahweh's work. But you could do the same thing. This is why I'm pouring my heart out to you. See, most people, right? Watch this, right? No one wants to talk about someone that's average. No one wants to talk about someone that fell. So you always have to be dream focused and goal oriented. Most people will lower their dreams to match their income expectations because they don't have any way of truly accomplishing their dreams. Well, I'm giving you the way. Where there is a way, and I'm giving you that way. It's called right knowledge. The book of Proverbs says, vision, without vision, where there's no vision, the people perish. Proverbs 29 and 18. So if you want your dreams bad enough, you'll find a way to get it. You'll never have anything until you discover what you want. I ask some people, what are your goals? What is your goals in life? I ask people when I first talk. This is how I could tell. I analyze people by talking to them. They don't even know they're being analyzed. When I talk to them, I listen more than I talk, right? When I'm communicating with most people. And then I ask them the questions. What is your passion in life? What is the one thing that you always wanted to be? They said, gee, I don't know. I can't deal with that kind of person right there. You understand? You don't even know what you want in life. You understand? You'll never have anything until you discover what you want. How can you have anything until you discover what you want? If you don't have a dream, how can you have a dream come true? Common damn sense, right? You got to find your why. So I'm going to ask you right now, what is your why? Write that down. What is your why? Start right there. What would you look for in a dream? As a career? More money? More recognition? Some of you want the fame, right? More travel? More freedom? Check this out, King. You said, Taz Doc, I'm all right. I hear what you're saying, but I'm all right, man. Well, good. That phrase, that aphorism, well, that's good enough, right? That'll get you in trouble and it'll keep you stationary. You got tired. You're going to be like that old lion that was on top of the hill, but he stayed there. I keep soaring. You understand? I'm not greedy. Stop being greedy if you are, but good is not good when better is expected. Good enough is not good when better is expected. Remember that aphorism. Remember who said it. Tazadaq. See, and only you'd have said, Tazadaq, I understand what you're saying, but I'm too old. I'm 66. Man, you're still a young man. You're older than your mind. You're as old as your cynicism, or you're as young as your dreams. Live all your dreams with passion. Keep your eyes upon the donut, not upon the hole in the donut. You understand? You're looking at the donut hole, man. You're distracted. I see this all the time in my videos. I try and tell people, hey, man, listen to me, the lecture. They're in the room chatting about someone else. Really? You came to my video to talk about other subjects. Why are you listening to me? You don't belong here. That's a debtor mentality, man. You're doing selective listening. If your dream is big enough, the facts don't count. Dream big. Dream big. See, I will accomplish my dreams of tomorrow by acting today. This is what I had to start seeing myself. I will accomplish my dreams of tomorrow by acting today. Let me tell you a little bit about myself, right? I was working in the computer networking industry, all kind of jobs, working for Dell. I worked for Canon. I worked for Verizon. I worked for a lot of the unfortunate 500 companies. I worked for Merrill Lynch, computer networking. I worked for the city of New York, computer network administrator, right? Coordinated administrator, right? Drew up titles, sound good. I still felt like a damn slave. You understand what I'm saying? I was still in debt. I still had a lower damn credit score than I have now. But after doing a little bit of research, when the spirit showed me, hey, secure party credit, the law of attraction. That was the Most High to show me this thing. No one gave me this. No one taught me this. This was the Lord. So after overcoming my skepticism of being a secure party creditor, that damn, this thing's too good to be true. You mean I could discharge debt? And then here comes all the naysayers. Hey, that doesn't work. It's going to get you in trouble and so on and so forth. After I was able to overcome all of that and place my faith in Yahweh Basham, Yahweh Shah, and in the power of the SPC, the Secure Party Creditor Opportunity. And after a few years, I developed this right knowledge, educational, and SPC training system. And I went to work hard body, achieving remedy in my works. Then I started to write my first book, The Infliction of Commerce. I, Tazadaq, and my wife, Yapa, are now financially free with a significant ongoing income. If I could do it, little Negro from the hood, that was supposed to be nobody, that wasn't supposed to be here, that wasn't supposed to make it, that wasn't supposed to be able to live like this, that wasn't never supposed to be able to escape the damn hood. If I could do it, you could do it too, family. That's all I'm saying to you, man. You hate me for that? You're envious of me for that? Do you understand? Check this out. I do seminars, right? I travel the country and sometimes internationally. I'm trying to go over here if Nicholas Lightfoot gets this place in Canada. I'm probably going to be doing a seminar in Canada. But my next seminar, I'm anticipating of doing in Atlanta, Georgia in 2 weeks. The next 2 weeks, so get ready now. I'm going to tell you it's going to sell out. And this seminar is going to be specifically on the 1099 OID and how to prepare and correct your credit and get a high credit score like me. My credit score is perfect. So why wouldn't you want to listen to someone that's speaking and teach him from example? I got a perfect credit score, man. I could walk into any organization and get whatever I want. What I'm saying is you could do the same thing too, man, if you listen and stop listening to the naysayers. Now, recently, doing a speaking engagement, right? A woman in the audience asked me a question that would have actually been very difficult for me to answer just a few years ago. And she said, on your journey of being a secure party creditor and try to have this new positive mind state that you have, what has actually been one of the lessons that has actually been the hardest for you to learn? And so without delay, right? I looked at the audience and I gave my honest, heartfelt answer. Without question, I said the hardest life lesson that I had to learn is that I have nothing to prove to anyone. You better learn that lesson right now, man. Because you always feel like I gotta prove yourself. Prove yourself to your wife. Prove yourself to your family. And that's keeping you stagnated, man. Without question, the hardest lesson that I've had to learn is that I have nothing to prove to anyone. Absolutely nothing. It took me a while to come to that conclusion, to get to that point. But I'm here. I'm here now. And I cannot describe the amount of peace, freedom, and happiness that this lesson has given to me, Tazadaq. And if you're not there yet, family, I'm here to help you get there. All you got to do is follow my example, emulate my lifestyle. You have nothing to prove to anyone, family. I keep telling people this, man. And I'll do everything within my power to convince you that that's right and exact. Facts. 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 Comparison. Watch this. Watch this. Watch this. Write this down, right? Write this down on your central processing unit, which is your brain, right? Write this down, right? Comparison equates death. Comparison equates death. Comparison is the thief or the grim reaper of joy. Tazadaq, so you know who said it. That's how we own it. I'm always soaring. And I found the theme of my life alters as time progresses. Right now, my motto is that I don't have to prove anything to anyone. Do you believe that before applying the Secure Party Creditor Law of Attraction and being a life coach, I didn't realize that proving myself was a concern of mine that carried a very intense albatross on my back? Do any of you feel compelled to prove yourself to others? Be honest. How many of you feel compelled to prove yourself to others? Would you like to learn how to get results and never have to prove yourself? See, I'm not sure if I would have actually realized it if I didn't choose the path that the Most High put me on. See, I started T-Doc. T-Doc is an acronym for True Disciples of Christ. That's us, the True Disciples of Christ. And you could go to www.truedisciplesofchrist.org and become a member of the website. If you're a male, you could try to join our camp, but we're going to evaluate you because maybe you could be one of us. I don't mean to sound like the Marines, but we don't want just an average man in our camp. We don't want some effeminate male that likes to argue. I had to kick a guy out of the camp. He got really into his emotions and okay, Roger that. He's like, well, a priest, you know, they will give people a second chance. We're not looking for those kind of men. We're looking for like King David's mighty men. A small faction, you understand? A small faction of warriors, of alpha males that's willing to die for this truth, man, and lay down their lives. And if you're not ready for that, don't you sign up for this camp, man. This is God's work, man. But nevertheless, right? So I started T-Doc, the True Disciples of Christ, website, business, and camp because I had developed total and complete faith in the secure party creditor law of attraction through Yahweh Basham Yahweh Shah. I saw it working in every aspect of my life. So I learned how it worked and I learned how to make it work for me. And so because of my success, I wanted to take my passion, teaching right knowledge, and teach you to apply it to your life. Wouldn't it be nice for you to change your financial status for the better? Wouldn't it? I know this subject is something that I love to talk about. I don't feel like it's work. I knew it is something that will make a difference in the people's lives that interact with me. And it does. I know this for certain. I've seen it change people's lives. I've had people get land. I have people save their homes. I have people get out of tickets. I have people avoid jail and so on and so forth. It wasn't me. I was just a help. I'm just a messenger. It was Yahweh that did it. It was God. This is God's work. It's not mine. I'm not out of place. I know what his power is coming through. I know I'm just an instrument. The Lord is just using me. You understand? It's not me. It's God's work. All glory, all praises are due to Yahweh Basham Yahweh Shah. To God in Christ. Now you can like that, understand it, believe it or not. If you're not spiritual, this is not for you. If you're not a spiritual man, this is not for you. You're trying to tap dance with all these philosophies. This is not for you, man. However, there must have been some latent beliefs about me needing to prove myself. You understand? So as I established this business, I suddenly felt the need to prove my ability to show my remedy works. And so debtors would actually come along and say, well, prove it. How we know that worked? How we know you was a computer scientist? And so on and so forth. How we know you got a degree in computer programming? Then, you know, I almost felt compelled to go and post my damn degrees online like a damn fool playing their game. But that's polemics. And so I realized, wait a minute. I don't have to prove myself to no one. But the debtors would say, show it, prove it. They would ask, how do we know you have a perfect credit score? Well, I tell you what. Why don't you walk into a damn Mercedes-Benz dealership and see if you could get an S 550 off the damn showroom floor with no money down? Why don't you try it out? I can't make this up, man. I got better things to do with my time. This ain't no damn gimmick like these damn naysayers are telling you. They say, how do we know that you rescind your social security number? Because we know, this is guy's name, Hellraiser tried it a few years ago. He didn't have success. Well, Hellraiser's not Tazadaq, man. I've been doing this for years, man. My record speaks for itself, man. 1,000 and up. Go back and look at my resume, man. When you type in some of these people videos, they only go back 2, 3, 4 years, man. You type Tazadaq's videos, and he's going to go back to almost when YouTube started. And I've been here since YouTube started. It's just that they was flagging my videos so much in the beginning, I stopped for a couple years. So right now, you could trace my videos back to at least 10 years. You understand? YouTube is only 13 years old, man. I'm not new to this. I'm not some Johnny come lately, overnight, pretend secure party creditor, man. I'm speaking from experience, man. So now I want to teach people about contract law and secure party creditor law of attraction. See, there's an temptation to prove that, hey, you have success with it and it's material. That temptation still arises sometimes when they say, well, you can't prove it. I want to show and prove. So, nah, I don't have to do that. So to demonstrate that your life can measure up to society's standard, that temptation within you want to prove it. Mr. Tazadaq, prove that you can measure up to the standards of good life. What makes you so different than us? Show us that you're living what the good life looks like. But you know what I learned, family? Taking this route is highly limiting. And this is why. When we are concerned, when we are worried about proving ourselves and our skills and our success to others, we become misaligned instead of going after the things we truly desire. We start to go after the things that we think other people need to see from us in order for them to take us seriously. I don't give a damn if neither one of you under the sounds of my voice right now take me seriously, because I know I'm living this out right and exact. And you're going to stay stuck if you don't receive this message. To those that can receive it, they're going to receive it. See, this is an issue, family, because with the secure party creditor law of attraction, you have to have a pure desire in order for your dreams to come through to fruition. You have to want something because you want it, not because you think other people will approve of it. I don't give a damn what other people think of me, man. When you allow someone else's opinion or evaluation of you be more important of that of yourself, then they're controlling you. See, I'm growing with the secure party creditor law of attraction, and I continue to see it working in my life on a daily basis. However, at this point, I truly understand I cannot make anyone believe that the secure party creditor law of attraction works for me. All I could do is live it out right and exact. Peace, God. And be honest about it. And those who are ready to hear the message, those who are ready to hear my message, will be joined to it. And so if you're joined to this message, I highly encourage you to go to the website now, truedisciplesofchrist.org/shop. Click on the link and become a secure party creditor today and order the books and DVDs that I mentioned in this video. I cannot prove the remedy and success to anyone else. I've had how many testimonies, if you look through my videos, that people can't, yeah, this really works, still wasn't good enough for them. See, what drives and motivates me is much greater than the symbols people are often looking for. I'm just not willing to reduce my desires down to these symbols. I'm not willing to desecrate myself on this lower level vibration. I'm driven by freedom. I'm driven by passion. And I'm driven by love. This is Yahweh's work. This is God's work. The hand of God touched Tazadaq, man. This is why I'm doing this. God touched me, man. Right hand to God, man. This is God's hand, man. The spirit is moving through me, man. This is what drives me. And my life is a reflection of the hand of God that touched me. And these three important factors that I mentioned. Freedom, passion, and love. What is love? If I ask you what love is, you can't even tell me what love is. What is love? It's rhetorical. I don't want you to answer it right here. I want you to answer it to yourself. Put it under the video. What is love? Someone tell me. Yeah, I want you to answer it under the video. What is love? You understand what I'm saying, family? Learning how to use the secure party creditor law of attraction isn't about achieving some state of perfection everyone else agrees with. It's not about that.
Mr. Tazadaq, my family don't talk to me anymore since I've been doing the secure party.
It's not about them agreeing with you, family. It's about following your own path and enjoying the adventure of the unfolding. It's about allowing good things to happen to you. It's not about forcing your life to conform to other people's standards. Conformity is failure. This is what happened in school, man. You go to school, you conform to the way that the public school system wants you to think. So there's no individuality. There's no freedom of thought. There's no freedom of expression. It's conformity. And you call this adaptation. I call it failure. I call it what it really is. So in other words, the secure party creditor law of attraction works. And I know it works. Regardless of how wealthy, how handsome, successful, healthy, muscular, or popular I am, I don't have to prove myself in regards to any of these factors. You understand? I may manifest a nice car, a successful business, but this does not mean I am truly a masterful creator. You understand? What makes me a masterful creator is whether or not I'm enjoying my life and doing thus saith the Lord. And then what I want to do as a free man. As long as I'm not violating the Lord's statutes and commandments of my Heavenly Father. See, I am, no matter what it may look like to anyone else. That's the will of a general. That's the role of a general. I'm giving you the role of my life. There are lots of things I deliberately create that may not seem too impressive to other people. Some people don't like my books. I like manifesting friendly people. I like manifesting new ideas and clarity. I like manifesting fun with my people, man. With my circle. I have a very small circle, man. I like manifesting good videos like these that will change your life. I already know right now I'm talking to you right now. I'm speaking to you right now. You know who you are. And this is going to change your life. You're finally going to bite down on your mouthpiece. And you're going to go out and fight for what you want. This is going to change your life right now. I'm speaking to you right now. And you know who you are. Do you understand? I like manifesting conversations about creation and the secure party creditor law of attraction. I like manifesting happiness. Don't come to me talking about depression. These things may not be too impressive to others, but these things are the things that make my day joyful, right? And exciting to me. I don't want to pretend that this is my success or my money that makes me a masterful creator. The money is not even worth a damn thing. Because those are just details. And they aren't really particularly important to me. You understand? One guy put on my video yesterday, it's very materialistic. That's just detail. That's only my way of showing you this works. I like creating financial freedom. But only because it allows me to live my life the way I want to live it out. Not because I have a love for money. Or he fell in love with money. No, you're looking at me through the wrong eyes, man. You better look with your mind, man. You're looking at with your physical eyes, which are the two most inaccurate organs in the body. Understand? I like creating financial freedom, but only because it allows me to live the life the way I want to live it. Not because I enjoy money or success on some deep personal level. This is an important message for me to share today because you need to hear this. Because I feel it needs to be said. You have an opportunity right here. You have an opportunity to create a joyful life for yourself. Will you take this opportunity? Wouldn't you love to live your dreams and be debt free? It's a question. You have an opportunity to create wonderful things that have meaning to you. Will you take this opportunity or will you let it pass it by like another YouTube video? I invite you to join me in evaluating your desires, your creations on a personal level without considering other people's opinions. Are you going after the things that really drives you is a question. That's a question I want you to seriously evaluate yourself on. Is your life reflective of your joy? This is all that matters. And if you need coaching on this topic, call me at 347-618-1783. Go to the website and donate for the coaching. Do you understand? It is not about them. It is not better. Is it not better, family, to give your true desires top billing in your life? Is that not better? Would you like to be invited to do the same? Well, I'm inviting you. There's no sense in trying to prove yourself to anyone through your creation, because in the end, other people's opinions have nothing to do with what really drives you. Ultimately, there's no competition. There is no winners and losers, and nobody's passing out prizes at the end for being perfect. Facts. Facts. Perfection, after all, is simply an enigma, right? Perfection is an enigma, and it doesn't actually exist. It's an intangible, just like fear. See, we have to live life, right? We have a life to live, and we all get to choose how to live it. Facts. We each get to do it differently. Facts. We each get to be unique. Facts. Life is a gift that is given to all of us by Yahweh, why Yahweh Shah, by God in Christ, right? But to make the most of it, we have to be honest about how we really want to live it out. This is how we own it. Use a secure party creditor law of attraction to be successful. The true understanding that a lot of what we think we want is not really what we want at all. See, I'm starting to see that many of our desires are not our true desires at all. Rather, they are simply our limiting beliefs disguised as our desires. What is a belief? A belief is something that's actually been instilled into you by others. Something that's actually been programmed into you by others. Something that's actually been taught to you by others. And whether it was true or not, remains to be unstated. But you accept it because you felt it came from a reliable source. So then when someone challenges that belief, even though it may not be a fact, the cognitive dissonance comes in, you feel uncomfortable, and you reject the challenge. So do people really want money because, case in point, watch this, right? Do people really want money because people value money and because money makes us happy? Or do people want money because we want to have unlimited abundance and access the ability to do, be, or have what we want? I contend the latter to be true. I contend that the true desire is not money at all, but rather it is really a desire to know that we are infinitely abundant and capable of having everything that we want. That's the true desire. Would you agree? Is it a desire to know your own unlimited power to create money? Money is actually irrelevant to our higher desires, as it's simply, you know, it's a condition we've actually placed on ourselves that often limits the way we accept our abundance. It is also a condition we use to measure and therefore limit our own abundance. The book of 1 Timothy 6 verse 10 says, "For the love of money is the root of all evil." It didn't say money. It says the love of money. So in other words, when we reach for money rather than reach for right knowledge or reach for love, and to reach for love, you got to know what is love. What is love? Put it under the video. What is love? So when we reach for money rather than reach for right knowledge, that we are infinitely abundant, our values as creators become cognitive on the money in our bank account. Therefore, we measure our worthiness of abundance by the number of dollar signs that we have. Do you understand? Do you understand? Regardless of how high these numbers are, it's always limited, right? The two richest Israelites, two of the richest Israelites ever, right? Watch this. For you Israelites, as I tell the doc, too materialistic. Okay. Watch this. King David, right? One of the richest Israelites ever, right? He said in the book of Psalms 62 and 10, place no trust in extortion or false hope in stolen goods. If your riches increase, do not set your heart on them. Don't set your mind on it. And his son Solomon said in the book of Proverbs 15 and 27, he who is greedy for unjust gain brings trouble on his household. But he who hates bribes will live. This government has brought troubles on his own household. You can't say Tyler Ducks like that. I'm just trying to teach you how to get a little bit remedy in this captivity. So instead of reaching for and accepting signs that we are infinitely abundant, most people reach for signs of their abundance that's limited, which is money. See, the more that we believe our abundance is conditional on the money in our account, the more limited we feel and the more disconnected we become from all forms of abundance, including but not limited to money. So what we really want is to be, we really want to feel worthy of our own unlimited abundance. But in order to feel worthy of our abundance, we cannot be concerned about proving our worthiness through the number of dollars in our bank accounts. Do you understand? We have to become more cognitive of all the many other things that we could do. So in other words, money is just one that we are abundant. It is not the end or to all abundant. This isn't to say that you can't attract money. But if you are interested in attracting money and it's not coming, it might be worth exploring your beliefs about why you want the money. If you only feel worthy of your abundance when the dollars are flowing, it is likely that your desires for money is simply a sign that you are reaching for limitations of your abundance rather than your expansion of it. Reach for the higher desires and uncover your knowledge of your infinite abundance. The money will flow more easily. You understand? And it won't carry the weight of limitations once it does. But even better, you will find yourself receptive to more and more forms of abundance. Now, can I ask you just a few more questions before I close this video, right? Why do we want social approval? Why do we value things like our Instagram account, our Facebook account, our Snapchat account? You understand? Social media in general. Why do so many people crave fame? Is it because those desires are truly reflective of what we really want? Does fame and social approval truly make our lives better? It's a question. Does it really give us our true desires? In my opinion, and I'm entitled to my own professional opinion, when someone reaches for social approval, what they are really craving is unconditional love. Watch this. Sisters, you really need to listen up, man. Because all of this feminism that's going on in the feminist movement has got your mind discombobulated, right? See, excuse me. We want others to prove their love for us so we could actually prove to ourselves we are worthy of being loved. You didn't hear me, sisters, because I'm talking in particularly to you. I'm talking to you men too, because some of you become codependent of a lot of these borderline relationships, right? We want others to prove their love for us so that we could actually prove to ourselves we are worthy of love. But unfortunately, when we reach for social approval over social media, we deny ourselves of the higher desires to be unconditionally loved. Stay the hell off of social media. You are social media junkies. You are social media crackheads. You're social media meth heads. Do you understand? I use it for my business. Not that you don't see me on social media chatting with people. It's not how I get down, man. It's a venue to spread my business. See, reaching for social media approval means that we are reaching for conditional love, not unconditional love. What they're posting on social media is not real. There's another side to their life. They're posting the best side of their life. They're giving you the fake. It's just like the fiat money that you're striving for. See, watch this. Listen up. Reaching for outside validation from others is simply another way of screaming into the UNI-verse, the universe, I am not worthy of love as I am. That's what you're saying. This is why you get blonde hair. When you're a so-called black woman, you're melanated, you got blonde hair. Unless you're a damn albino, what the hell are you doing with blonde hair? You got purple hair, you got red hair. You change like a damn chameleon. You got fake boobs, fake buttocks, fake anything. Because essentially what you're saying, and I know this hurts, but you need to receive it. Essentially what you're saying is I'm not worthy of love as I am. Now, can you watch this? And please don't take this offensively, right? It's meant for edification. It's meant to teach, right? Can you imagine a so-called black man that has no connection, with China whatsoever, walking around getting his eyes pulled back like that? Because a lot of so-called black women do it, getting their eyes stretched back like that, trying to look Asian and going around, you know, trying to speak Asian. Trying to speak Asian, you see what I'm saying? And so, you say, hey, brother, why are you talking like that? He said, because I'm Chinese. And I said, well, it says right here that you're Israelite. Or, you know, you was born in America. So why are you talking like that? Why are you using the fake Asian accent? You're not even Asian and so on and so forth. So he said, no, I feel inside that I'm Asian. I'm Asian. Hurry up and buy. You see what I'm saying? But, and I'm not being comical. I want you to listen, man, because there's a message in this. So what it is people are confused. They don't know who they are anymore. So I ask the question, who are you? So even though he's born a Moor or Israelite, he wants to say, I'm Asian. I'm Asian on the inside. But you look like a Moor. You look like an Israelite. You understand what I'm saying? And so you got a lot of people running around doing the same thing. You got people running around saying, oh yeah, I'm sure you how ridiculous that is, right? You got people that are running around and say, well yeah, I was born a male on the outside, but I'm a female on the inside. It's the same thing. You see what I'm saying? Question it. So that makes me question the efficacy of teaching when teaching is actually creating learned monsters. You understand? And I'll start right there with that, right? So my point is reaching for outside validation from others is simply another way of screaming out in the universe, I'm not worthy of love as I am. When you do these things, you know, like the, the parable that I gave of the Moor or the Israelite trying to be Asian, trying to use the Asian accent and so on and so forth and saying, well, this is how I feel on the inside. People look at him like he's ridiculous. But you got a government that embraced certain lifestyles of people saying there's something that they're not. You see what I'm saying? And then when you speak out against it, they call you politically incorrect. See, what you're saying essentially, I'm only worthy of love when others approve of me. You see what I'm saying? So as a result, what happens? So women get on social media and they're twerking, twerking, twerking. And these women got daughters. What are they teaching their daughters? They dress nude, right? You see women on social media all of the time. So-called women that's calling themselves Israelites that are members of camps. Stop me where I'm lying at. Stop me where I'm lying at. That's members in camps that get on online with the damn cleavage out. And they have a damn blouse on so tight and so low that the damn boobs look like two ass cheeks. Stop me where I'm lying at. So then instead of getting our true desires, which is unconditional love, when we do these kind of things, we only reinforce our limiting beliefs that we must gain other people's approval in order to be loved. And that is sick. So the Heavenly Father raised up Kahan Tazadak as the healer. This is the hand of God, man. The hand of God. So this pursuit ultimately makes us feel unworthy. These people are doing this because they feel unworthy. Sis, you got your hair done blind because you feel unworthy. You're unacceptable as you are. Because if something is good enough, we leave it as it is, right? Talk back to me. Facts. Facts. See, join us further and further away from our true desires to be loved. You think this is the answer. It's not the answer. It's taking you away from who you really are. I know you better than you know yourself. Brothers and sisters, man. This is just something to consider. Sometimes the things we say we want really aren't what we want at all. This is right knowledge, man. This is God's work. This is awakening the sleeping giant in you. This is just something to consider, folks. Sometimes the things we're reaching for are actually pulling us further and further away from our true desires. Stop the social media whoredom. So if there's something you've actually been reaching for and it hasn't been coming and it's been making you feel bad that it hasn't been coming, I say there must be a limiting belief in that equation. I deal with mathematics. That doesn't come out right and exact. It don't add up to me. It is quite possible that the dream you're reaching for isn't truly yours. It's not truly your desires. Someone else supplanted that in your mind. Get your mind right, King. Get your mind right, Queen. But rather, it's your belief. Your belief is not your desire. Your belief is something that's actually been stored in your head by someone else. It's what you've been taught by your parents, by your educational system, by your peers. It is a belief. It is your belief limiting disguise as your desires. It's not what you really want. It's not who you really are. It changed you into something other than what you was. What the Creator intended you to be. It's part of the program, and you still deny that you're locked into the matrix. When will you admit that something is really wrong? When will you stop calling this a damn conspiracy theory? As I mentioned earlier, right? When we reach for money instead of our true desires, which is right knowledge, our unlimited abundance, we reach for signs that teach us our abundance is limited. This is what you're doing with the social media whoredom. When we reach for social approval instead of our true desires, which is unconditional love. What is love? Put it on the video right now. What is love? We reach for signs that prove to us that we are only loved conditionally. And so the society is sick. If there is something you wasn't, that isn't coming to you, right? If there's something you want that isn't coming to you, do yourself a favor. Dig a little bit deeper. What do you really want? And is this thing you're asking for your true reflection of your inner desire? Truth be told, you can attract anything you want into your life with the secure party credit, the law of attraction. But it is my belief, which is an actual fact, because it manifests itself, that to truly experience the expansion we crave, to truly feel love, worthy, and abundant, we have to be willing to let go of the limitations that tell us we could only have these things conditionally. This doesn't mean you have to be poor. like a lot of Israelites are teaching. And it doesn't mean you have to be a loner. In fact, my point is quite the opposite. It just means in reaching beyond the dollars and beyond the likes on social media, right? You open yourself up to a much greater flow of abundance and love than you could ever achieve as long as you are chasing at the limited forms of these true desires. Reach for abundance in all forms and let the UNI verse show you that money is just the beginning, family. Reach for unconditional love. But what is love? And come to learn that you can feel love exactly as you are. The Most High, the creator of this boundless universe, don't make mistakes. He don't create mistakes. You're good as you are. Are you telling me God made a mistake? Reach a little farther and find your true desires. I believe this to be the true path of our happiness and the true path beyond the limitations that hold us back from the things that we really want. That's how we own it. It's God's work, not mine. And so below this video, I posted a daily progress report. I'll also try to upload this to my website. Better yet, I'll post a link to the daily progress report and you go to the website and you download it. But you have to enroll as a member to download this daily progress report.